I am PM Rajendiran, leading Lipidomics platform in the Metabolomics core. Today I am going to talk about my current platform, Untargeted Reverse Phase UPLC-QTOF MSMS-based Lipidomics, a global lipidomic profiling of complex biological systems. First, let us see what is Lipidomics. Lipidomics is an identification and a quantification of thousands of cellular molecular lipid species found in an organism. Lipidomics itself is a distinct discipline due to uniqueness and functional specificity of lipids related to other metabolites. Lipids have the following key biological functions, such as act as structural component to cell membrane, serve as energy storage sources, and participating in cell signaling. Identification of lipids is very challenging, exciting, and also interesting due to structural diversity of lipids. What are lipids? Why lipids? Lipids are larger group of naturally occurring organic compounds which include fatty acids like palmitic acid, myristic acid, oleic acid, arachidonic acid, etc. Glycolipids like monoglyceride, diglyceride, triglycerides. Serial lipids like cholesterol and cholesterol esters. Phospholipids or glycerol phospholipids, already talk about that. PC, PE, PG, PS, PI, and PA. Sphingolipids like ceramide and sphingomyelin. So these individual lipid species have been associated with the evaluation of different diseases. Lipidomics is crucial for understanding cellular physiology and pathology in human, plants, and indeed all organisms. Lipidomics can explain the disease pathology and treatment of many diseases like cardiovascular disease, metabolic syndrome, lipid storage disease, Alzheimer's, and cancer. A better understanding of lipidomics could significantly improve diagnostic medicine as well as provide novel treatment options. So what we are looking for in lipidomics? What are the informations lipidomics will provide for the investigators? Lipidomics will provide a comprehensive lipidomic profile of complex biological systems like tissues, cell lines, and body fluids like plasma, serum, saliva, and urine, etc. These lipid profiles reveal the lipid alteration that occur in metabolic disorders like diabetes, obesity, stroke, hypertension, and atherosclerosis. Profiling lipid is also help us to identify metabolic pathways which are activated or deactivated when a cell shifts from its physiological condition to pathological condition or other physiological condition. Integrating lipidomics to other omics like genomics, proteomics, and metabolomics will provide a powerful tool to elucidate molecular mechanisms associated with lipid disorders and identify potential biomarkers and novel therapeutic targets. So lipidomics is the subset of metabolomics. Let us see how the lipidomics differs from metabolomics. Metabolomics is an identification and a quantification of metabolites including lipids in biological system. The molecular weight is less than 2000 Dalton, which includes amino acids, fatty acids, sugars, vitamins, polyamines, TCA metabolites, tryptophan metabolites like kynurenine, tryptophan kynuric acid, and so on. Lipidomics is an identification and a quantification of different class of lipids, which includes simple free fatty acid to complex phospho and sphingolipids. The molecular weight of lipids also less than 2000 Dalton. In metabolomics, both lipids and metabolites extract in a single step. Take a biological sample, crush with a crushing solvent, precipitate the protein, take the soup, dry under nitrogen, and reconstitute it into the mass spec. Whereas in the metabolomic, in lipidomics, lipids were enriched by liquid-liquid extraction. Take the biological sample, add a series of aqueous and organic solvents, and the organic layer containing lipids carefully separated from the aqueous layer, dried and reconstituted with upright buffer and put it into mass spec. The identification of metabolites and lipids in metabolomics based on precursor ion accurate mass, whereas in lipidomics, the lipids are identified based on matching precursor ion and the product ion. In lipidomics, in metabolomics, we do not get the fatty acid information of complex lipids. Whereas in lipidomics, the MS2-based data acquisition helps us to identify the fatty acid chain information. In metabolomics, we can identify only low molecular weight lipids, whereas in lipidomics, we can identify all low and high molecular weight lipids. By enriching lipids using lipid-lipid extraction allows us to identify different class of lipids, low and high molecular weight lipids, and complex lipids. And also, the MS2-based product ion data acquisition helps us to identify fatty acid chains and also polar head group informations. So the main objective of the code is to provide a comprehensive lipidomic profile for the identification of different class of lipids using shotgun lipidomics. The core will provide expertise and the facilities for generating high quality data for the funded and the proposed research. If a new investigator wanted to apply for an exploratory grant like R21 or R03 or seed grant or a pilot grant, we will provide a preliminary data to support the application. Whereas the fund for funded projects, if an investigator wants to expand his research to lipidomics, we provide detailed comprehensive lipidomic data. The course also provide necessary equipments and the expertise for researchers, allow them to identify and measure lipid biomarkers. So this is a overview of steps involving in lipidomics of complex biological samples. So the major steps involved lipid extraction, separation, and mass spectrometry-based detection, spectral analysis, data normalization, and delineation of class-specific lipid profiles, and altered pathways and their functional studies. Lipids were extracted from biological samples by liquid-liquid extraction after spike the internal standards. So the dried lipid extract reconstitute appropriate buffer and inject it into mass spec. Reverse phase chromatography is used for the separation of lipids. The lipids were detected using LC-MS in both positive and negative mode. The lipids are identified by database search, the lipid blast, already talked about that, by matching precursor ion and the product ion. After filtering, imputation, log transformation, and data normalization, delineate the class-specific lipid profiles, followed by pathway mapping and their functional studies. So this is the structural diversity of commonly analyzed lipids. As I already talked about these things, I'm not going to talk in detail this. Just I can point out only the key difference between the different classes. First, the glycerol lipids and the phosphoglycerol lipids contains glycerol backbone. And the phosphoglycerol lipids and the sphingolipids contain polar head groups, whereas the glycerolipids do not contain polar head groups. In glycerolipids and the phosphoglycerolipids, the fatty acid linked through ester bond, whereas in sphingolipids, the fatty acid linked through amide bond. This is very, very important for detecting these class of lipids using mass spectrometry. So using MS1 full scan MS and also product ion scan, we have identified a characteristic head group fragment of various class of lipids. The table shows different class of lipids with their characteristic head group fragment. PC, PE, PG, PS and PI belongs to phospholipids. They produced a characteristic fragment corresponding to loss of polar head groups. For example, phosphatidylcholine PC produced 184 as a major peak corresponding to phosphocholine. Whereas phosphoethanol amine undergoes neutral loss of 141 due to phosphoethanol amine. Similarly, other phospholipids produced a characteristic fragment corresponding to the loss of characteristic polar head groups. Ceramides and sphingomyelin come under sphingolipids. Ceramides readily undergo dehydration because of this, because ceramides contain the sphingolipids contain, so this is a sphingoid backbone. Because of these two hash, so it readily undergo dehydration. It readily undergo dehydration to give 264 as a major fragment due to loss of two water molecule and the SN2 fatty acyl chain. Sphingomyelin exhibit 184 as a major peak, similar to phosphatidylcholine in phospholipids, because both contains phosphocholine as a head group. So this 184 corresponds to loss of phosphocholine. Steroid, the steroid lipids exhibit 364 as a major fragment corresponding to cholestine moiety. So this is the whole moiety. This is a cholestine moiety. Due to this, we can get the 368 fragment. Unlike other class of lipids, as I told you, glycerolipids do not contain polar head groups. But these class of lipids, when you put it into mass spec, they produced neutral loss of ammoniated fatty acids. See how different lipid classes behave in mass spectrometry. How the nature chosen the structure of sexual diversity of lipids, how the mass spec helps. So these class of this characteristic head group fragments are used to identify and to quantify lipid in complex biological systems. And this fragment is also used to perform precursor ion scan and neutral loss scan for the analysis of specific class of lipids. For the analysis of specific class of lipids in biological samples, we extracted lipid from human pooled plasma using a modified bleach dyer methodology. The lipid were extracted from biological samples after spiking internal standards, one per class listed here, addition of by adding equal volume of water, dichloromethane and methanol. The bottom layer containing organic, the bottom layer containing lipid were carefully separated from this aqueous layer and dried under nitrogen, injected into mass spec. The dried lipid extract were injected onto 1.8 micron water acuity reverse phased column, which was heated to 55 degrees. The binary mobile phase contains buffer A 40% isocyanitril, and a buffer B contains 10% isocyanitril, 90% isopropanol. Both buffer A and buffer B contains 10 millimolar ammonium acetate. The flow rate is 400 microliters per minute. The injection volume is 5 microliters. The runtime is only 15 minutes. There are two kinds of quality controls were used to monitor instrument performance and the sample preparation. To monitor instrument performance, we use matrix-free mixture of internal standards. 10 microliter of 100 picomole per microliter stock matrix-free internal standard mixture were dried and reconstituted with the appropriate buffer and put it into mass spec and inject multiple times to check the stability and reproducibility. And if there is no drift and retention time, then only we'll continue to start the instrument, otherwise we stop. So it has to pass this first quality control. If it is not, we call the engineer, ask him to fix the issue. To monitor the lipid extraction process, we use pooled human plasma and the test pools. The test pools generated by small aliquots from the test sample. So lipids were extracted from these two quality controls after spiking the internal standard and processed along with the test sample and injected between every 10 sample in the given batch. So this is the chromatogram of human plasma lipid extract in the positive mode. As is seen in the figure, different class of lipids elute in the different retention time. The low molecular weight lysolipids. Lysolipids usually contain one fatty acid chain. Lysolipids and monoglycerides elute in the lower gradient, whereas the high molecular weight lipids, triglycerides and the cholesterol esters elute at the higher gradient. Lipids like PCPE, sphingomyelin, diglyceride and ceramides elute in the middle of the gradient. The separation of lipids in the negative mode consists with the positive mode, where different class of lipids also elute at different retention time. The free fatty acids elute in the lower gradient. The anionic lipids like PG, PI, PS and PI elutes retention time between 5.5 to 9.5. To check the reproducibility and stability, the same sample run multiple times, more than 20 times, and overlaid on the top of each other. As seen in the figure, there is no drift in the retention time, shows very excellent stability and reproducibility. We also check the reproducibility and stability by running same sample three different days, 50 injections per day, and analyzed the internal standards. So the percentage RST of the internal standard is less than 10%. So the excellent stability and reproducibility. Tanu is going to show the data in our next presentation. We used data-dependent MS2 acquisition for data collection by selecting top 20 ions using a dynamic exclusion in both positive and negative mode. We ramped collision energy from 20 to 50. Lipid blast library used for the identification of lipids by matching product ion under the precursor ion. Multiquant, a vendor software used for the quantification of lipids. Internal standards used for the normalization of different class of lipids. Using my current methodology, I have identified around 500 unique lipids, which includes different class of lipids. Phospholipids like PC, PE, PG, PS, PI, PA, then plasminyl PE and plasminyl PC. Sphingolipids like ceramides and sphingomyelin, and glycerolipids like monoglyceride, diglyceride and triglyceride. After we established the method, I have been successfully running the following sample for the clients. Tissues like prostate, breast, skin, nerve, kidney, adipose, liver, and retina, etc. And then biofluids like plasma, serum, saliva, and urine, etc. The cell lines from different disease phenotype and also fecal samples. As a case study, I am going to talk about delineate the lipidomic alteration in prostate cancer. For the identification of lipidomic signature in prostate cancer, I employed a new cohort of N equal 3 biological replicates of prostate derived cell lines, RWPE, a benign prostate cell line, then prostate cancer cell line VCAP, LINCAP, D145, PC3, and 2R VV1. Using my current methodology, I have identified 461 total lipids. There are 192 different lipids were identified between benign and prostate cancer. This is a PCA score plot based on 192 differential lipid. As seen in the figure, all three biological replicates of individual cell lines and also our quality control pooled plasma and test plasma grouped together. The pooled human plasma is entirely different from other cell lines, so it's located away from all samples. As expected, the test pool, a small aliquot from the test samples, is located at the center of the PCA plot. and all other biological replicates of cell lines, like biological replicate of normal RWV cell line, and other cancer cell lines, LINCAP, DU145, PC3 and 2 RBV1, are grouped together. So this data suggests the quality of the data is exceptionally good. So this is a list of most significant lipids between RWP and other cancer cell lines. As seen in the list, most of the differential lipids are phospholipids and glycerolipids. Glycerolipids like DG, TG, then another TG, the series of TG and DGs. And the phospholipids like PE, that ether PE, that is plasminal PE, and the lyso-PE, and all other PE. So this suggests phospholipid metabolism and the glycerolipid metabolism is increased during cancer progression. Here the G-score plot showing 192 significant lipids. The hierarchical cluster showing separate cluster for benign and prostate cancer. So this is the benign, this is the all prostate cancer. The color code represent expression of lipids. So the shaded green represent upregulation of a lipid. The shaded red represent a downregulation of a lipid. Each column represent individual cell lines, and each rows represent differential lipids. As seen in the figure, the RWP cell lines nicely separated from cancer cell lines. So from the differential lipids, we have concluded phospholipid metabolism and glycerolipid metabolism is increased during cancer progression. So here is the histogram showing the levels of phospholipids and glycerolipids in prostate-derived cell lines. As we've seen in the figure, the phospholipids like PE36-5 and the plasminal PE38-5 and the glycerolipids like DG32-0 and TG56-7. In all four cases, the cancer cell line shows elevated levels of phospholipids and the glycerolipid than the normal RWP cell line. To define the disease phenotype, I employed BCAP and LINCAP antigen dependent cell line and the PC3 D145 antigen independent cell line. We have identified 124 differential lipids between these two phenotypes. Out of 462 lipids. So if the PC score plot based on 152 differential lipids between antigen dependent and antigen independent cell lines, as you've seen in the figure, different class of cell lines are grouped together. The antigen-dependent cell line VCAP and LINCAP clearly separated from antigen-independent cell line D145 and PC3. Here's a differential lipid between antigen-dependent and antigen-independent cell lines. Here also, the table shows most of the differential lipids are glycerolipids like TG, 51, DG34-0, TG48-1, and other TGs, and the phospholipids like plasminal PE, PC, and the PC42-1, and so on. So this suggests both phospholipid metabolism and glycerolipid metabolism are associated with antigen-dependent and antigen-independent prostate cancer. So this is the G-score plot for 122 most significant lipids. The hierarchical cluster showing different cluster for different phenotypes. As you've seen in the figure, the antigen-dependent cell lines, BCAP and LINCAP, clearly separated from antigen-independent cell lines, D145 and PC3. From the list of differential lipids, we have concluded that the glycerolipid metabolism is associated with antigen-dependent cell antigen-dependent prostate cancer. So the phospholipids metabolism is associated with the antigen-independent cell lines. So it is the histogram showing the levels of glycerolipid or the glycerophospholipids in antigen dependent and antigen independent prostate cancer cell lines. As we seen in the figure, so glycerolipids like TG441, DG340 are significantly elevated in antigen dependent cell line NCAP and VCAP, whereas the phospholipids like PE48 and PC4210 were significantly elevated in antigen independent cell line D145 and PC3. So this preliminary data suggests our current methodology defined the disease phenotype more accurately. In summary, using my current methodology, we have been successfully running some biological samples like tissues, biofluids, and cell lines for clients. This method allows us to identify more than 500 unique lipid species within 15 minutes run. The method shows excellent reproducibility and stability. Based on preliminary data on prostate cancer, cell line lipidomic profiling defines the disease phenotype more accurately. Thanks for your attention, and I'm happy to take questions if you have. No, I did not do any subtractions. Mitochondrial I did with different cell lines, not with, yeah. I did mitochondria cell lines, yes.
Okay.